wants to take it. We'll go start with Brett. A lot of newcomers in the front court. What have you done to help them get in a place where they can contribute immediately?
I would say just keep building confidence in them. You know, just let them know this is the same game you played in high school, and there's no difference. You know, there's still five people on the court, so just keeping it simple and sweet, just so they can understand that this is the same game.
Go ahead, Lil.
The numbers that y'all have down there, just how much easier could that possibly make it for you guys to kind of save your legs some throughout the season, not play as many minutes, and also have the production that those younger guys are going to bring?
It's going to be very helpful just because, like you said, we are deep in every position. So, you know, we have that mindset where it's the next man up. You know, some guys are not going to have a good night, but we can trust in each other that somebody is, you know. And with having a deep team like that, it's easy to sacrifice and rely on something like that.
Go ahead and stay in the front.
Speaking of the front court, just your thoughts on the new guys that have come in, Jethro and them, and I guess Reggie and Robert may play some at the four too. But with those newcomers, just your early impressions of them, and also what have you seen from Abdul this summer?
I would say with the young guys or with the new guys, they love learning. You know, they're quick learners. You know, they're asking questions. They want to get better every day, and that's all you can ask for as a leader on this team and as a teammate of the new guys. You know, and then with Abdul, he's the same. He's the same guy. You know, he's getting better every day. You know, he's getting better at the leadership role. He's expanding his game. You know, he's doing everything that we asked him.
We'll have Brett over here on the left.
With all the pieces on this team that can flow between different positions, just how many lineup combos are there for this team right now? How are y'all kind of managing, figuring out what the strengths and weaknesses are of each one?
Yes, I would say we're figuring out the strengths and weaknesses, and we do have a lot of ways we can play people, which was, I guess, like the mindset of Coach Holly, you know, with recruiting the new guys, you know, so. At any given night, we can go small, we can go big, we can go regular, we can go really big where you might put me at the three or something, you know. So we have all different ways that we can attack the game, which is helpful and to make the game easier to all of us.
We'll stay on Eric's left and then we'll come back over to the right.
Q mentioned a minute ago a couple words that hadn't been uttered around here a whole lot the last few years, and that's the goal of a national championship kind of thing. Just what's kind of the, for you and him in particular, the sense of urgency to get to the tournament. You guys have never been to the NCAA tournament things. And is that hunger and that sense of urgency, do y'all kind of feel that right now?
Absolutely, you know, because coming out of high school, you know, we came from winning programs, you know, so we already had our heads up high when we first got here. And when we first got here, we told ourselves that we want to get this program back on top, you know, so that's why we sacrificed and stayed all 4 years, you know, and we love our teammates and we just want to go out with a bang, and a national championship is our whole mindset.
Kind of building off that question, I know you guys wanted to be in the tournament last year, but how can you use that NIT experience in the long postseason run you had there to build off of that?
It's a great motivational tool just because we were right there, you know. There's some games that slipped out of our hands, but right now we're focused on where we're taking one game at a time, and we're not gonna let either one of them, none of them, slip out of our hands this year. We're not gonna let no games affect us this year, so it won't hurt us in the long run.
We'll go back to the second round.
Similar to what Joel asked, the expectations are probably higher than they ever been since you've been here. What's it been like this offseason, just sort of dealing with that and trying to focus on your goals?
It's been great, you know, because we have a great team, we have a great core, and everybody's on board to be successful, you know. So when you have guys like that in the locker room that's on the same page as you, it's mind-blowing because, you know, where this program was and where, you know, us guys are taking it now. So.
Anything else for Aric before we let him go?